Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. From Taxi, Marilu Henner. Dick Martin. And Fannie Flagg. As we play the star-studded big money match game, PM. And now, here's the star of match game PM, Gene Rivers.
Thank you, friends. How kind of you to join us here on this auspicious occasion. Well, you're a beautiful bunch of coconuts, I must say. We got a tie and jacket on. Oh, lovely, lovely, lovely. I'll get to you in a moment. Right now, I'd like you to join me in greeting Forrest Reed and Connie Fisk. Would you do that? Thank you. We welcome both of you. Thank you. And before we begin the game, we'd like to find out a little bit about each of you. And Connie, we'll begin with you, if you please.
Okay, I'm from Minneapolis, Minnesota. I work as a waitress. I'm out here in California for my first time on my honeymoon.
Oh, how nice.
Thank you.
How long have you been married, Connie?
It's been about 6 weeks now.
Well, I'm glad you found a little time to visit us, Connie.
Thank you.
Forrest, we'd like to find out about you.
Well, I live in Woodland Hills, California, and I work for an insurance company, and I'm married to a lady who's an aspiring actress, Angela.
Mm-hmm.
And other than that...
Well, good luck to both of you. Here on Match Game PM, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of our stars as you possibly can, and the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner, and we'll go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $20,000. So, good luck. Connie, you can have A or B.
I'd like to have A, please.
A? All right. Fannie Flagg's boyfriend said...
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. There have been so many, dear.
He didn't say that.
Oh, right.
Fannie Flagg's boyfriend said, people ask me if Fannie Flagg is really Southern. I'll tell you how Southern she is. Her blank is full of grits. That's how Southern she is. Her blank is full of grits.
Charles is finished. She's just writing his Christmas card.
Here we go. Fannie Flagg's boyfriend said, people ask me if Fannie Flagg is really Southern. Well, I'm going to tell you how Southern she is. Her blank is full of grits.
T-shirt.
T-shirt.
She's always wearing those T-shirts.
She doesn't do that anymore. She used to a lot, every day.
It's going to be one of those shows.
That's right. Her T-shirt is full of grits. Don't you look nifty with a tie and jacket and all
Thank
that.
You.
Very Eastern there, Cap. Yes, sirree.
I said her corn pone is full of grits.
Her corn pone?
I was trying to think of all the Southern things that Fannie would...
It's very Southern and very wrong.
I know.
Okay, Brett.
Well, one night he had her in the rumble seat.
Okay.
Oh. In the rumble seat.
In the rumble seat, and he made a grab for it, and sure enough, her cleavage was full of corn.
Her cleavage was full of grits. All right, Charles.
Bra.
Bra would seem to me to be the definitive response. Although I think Connie had the same idea when she said T-shirt. Yes.
Yeah.
What do you say?
Oh, I said kitchen. Sorry.
Her kitchen is full of grits.
No, she cooks a lot.
Oh, I see.
All right. I'm afraid Mary Lou and I are... I said her house is full of grits.
Her house is full of grits. You're having a momentary lapse, are you? Okay.
The grit house.
Now, Fannie, you're going to tell us the truth.
Yes. Purse.
Purse. They use it as a form of money. Yes, a rate of exchange, her purse there. Okay, Forrest, let's see what we've got for you right here. Jimmy Carter said...
Howdy.
No, he said, having my mother-in-law in the White House has its disadvantages. Yesterday, Ms. Lillian walked into the cabinet meeting and told me to blank. Having my mother live in the White House has its disadvantages. Yesterday, Ms. Lillian walked into the cabinet meeting and told me to blank. Got one? Don't say it yet. Here we go, Forrest. Jimmy Carter said, having my mother live in the White House has its disadvantages. Yesterday, Ms. Lillian walked into the cabinet meeting and told me to...
Come home.
Come home. Come on home, Jimmy.
My mother used to do it.
Is that what your mother used to say?
I didn't hear what his aunt said.
He says, my mother said, come home. What do you say to that?
I said, hush your mouth.
Hush your mouth. Very good. Hush your mouth, Jimmy. That's a good one.
She said, oh, Jimmy, get yourself a hanky.
Get a hanky. You sure you have a clean hanky?
What my mother used to say, put a sweater on.
Put a sweater on. Put a sweater on already, you'll catch cold. Okay, Mary Lou, we come to you.
I know.
Having Ms. Lillian walked into the cabinet meeting and said...
said, go wash your hands before dinner.
Oh, that's a good one. Go wash your hands before dinner. Mothers say that. All you mothers out there, don't you say that? No, you don't say that. Okay.
I say leave home.
Yeah. What do you say?
I say.
Really, what did you say?
Having children.
Jimmy Carter's case, because of his dental work, brush my teeth.
Brush my teeth.
Go brush your teeth.
Okay, told me to brush my teeth.
Yes.
All right, Fannie.
She said, Jimmy, resign.
No,
he didn't say it.
Ms. Lillian said that. Fannie wouldn't say a thing like that. So here we are at the end of the first round. Round two coming up right after this. Pay attention now. Here we go. Round two coming up. Okay, Connie went first last time. Since the score is tied zip to zip, Forrest, we'll ask you to go first this time.
I'll take A.
A it is. Brenda said, my husband finally agrees that we keep our bedroom too cold. Because when we woke up this morning, we discovered a blank in bed with us. We finally agreed that we keep the bedroom too cold because when we woke up this morning, we discovered a blank in bed with us. Chuck, you ready?
Yo!
Okay.
Yo.
Brenda said, my husband finally agrees that we keep our bedroom too cold. Because when we woke up this morning, we discovered a blank in bed with us.
A walrus?
A walrus. Came all the way down from the North Pole, huh? Oh, that would be frightening to find all that blubber lying next to you in the morning, wouldn't it? What did you say?
The same area, only I got an Eskimo.
An Eskimo is a good response. All right, Brad.
You never complained about finding all that blubber next to you. Polar bear!
Polar bear. Both good responses, Charles.
That hurt. That hurt. You put the things down.
Yes.
And I don't have any socks on. And yes, you put it down here, and the audience, of course, thinks this thing cost $1 million and is something to catch them. My foot gets every sharp end for 6 years.
Oh. Polar bear. What we are looking for, Ms. Mary Lou, honey, is a walrus.
No, polar bear.
Polar bear. Okay.
I don't hear walrus brought up at many conversations.
No, I don't. People don't talk about polar bear. That's more indigenous to the, you know, Eskimo land and all that sort of thing. What do you say?
I thought it was an Eskimo family.
A whole Eskimo family.
You got the whole family. Oh,
that was a king-size bed, I suppose. Okay, Connie, this one is yours. The pilot on El Cheapo Airlines announced, ladies and gentlemen, we are about to attempt a takeoff.
Whoa.
So everybody blank. El Cheapo Airlines. Okay. Connie, the pilot on El Cheapo Airlines announced, ladies and gentlemen, we are about to attempt a takeoff. So everybody blank.
Move to the rear.
Oh, really? What would that do, Connie?
That would get the nose up in the air.
Oh, that would get the nose up. Yes, of course. And you got to get your nose up if you're going to take off.
Well, they're going to need a lot of help, so I said everybody pray.
Pray! Very good.
It was so good.
She's batting 1,000.
Oh, no, honey, you know me. I'm a Girl Scout in my heart of hearts, and I believe in helping and praying, too. But you got to help. I said, flap your arms.
Flap your arms, yeah. Hot attempt to take off. Everybody flap the arms.
Charlie, he's got the same thing.
Now, don't do that to
fortunately,
him.
Fortunately, there's no song with it. Wave your arms.
Wave your arms. Now, Brett, that wasn't very nice of you to do that. Hello, Marilu.
Hello.
We're about to attempt to take off, so everybody...
Well, I was thinking of, like, the Flintstones. Remember how they got their car started? So I said, shuffle your feet.
Oh, yeah, the way they ran real fast right, and want everybody to get going there.
Right.
Rotten.
Rotten.
You're cute, but... Okay.
I was anticipating turbulence, so I said, everyone use your bag.
Oh. All right.
said everybody push.
Oh. Well, here we go to round three. And as you can see, we have a real hard-fought battle here. It's a close game. Score is tied. Forrest went first last time, so Connie will ask you to go first this time, A or B?
Let's hope for A.
Let's go for A.
Let's.
Okay. Norm said, did you hear about the mad scientist who crossed a cow with a kangaroo? I'll tell you. I don't know what he got, but to milk it, you have to get on a blank. Crossed a cow with a kangaroo. Here we go, Connie. Norm said, did you hear about the mad scientist who crossed a cow with a kangaroo? I don't know what he got, but to milk it, you have to get on a blank.
Ladder?
Ladder. Oh, you see, kangaroos go like that, you see.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, but then you get on a hop?
What do you say there?
How about a pogo stick?
Pogo stick! Don't you try that.
No. I had a pogo stick when I was a kid, too.
Because the San Andreas Fault is very close to us, sir. Okay.
Once more, I would like to explain the rules of the game to the audience.
Yes?
The trick is to match.
Right.
Do not cheer that which does not match.
Just...
We cheer that which matches.
Okay.
That
one's
doing well.
Thank you.
Stool.
A stool. A bar stool.
A stool is equal. Well,
milkmaids always have milking stools.
Right.
And that's what he had in mind. Yes.
No. I like him to wipe down. You know, I like to watch him go up and down. I said pogo stick.
Pogo stick is the definitive answer.
I said, the other one is trampoline.
Trampoline would be a... The co-definitive answer. What did you say?
They really mixed a kangaroo and a cow.
They did.
Sounds like an utter disaster to me.
You did that on purpose. Pogo stick is a good response. Okay, so here we are. You ready?
I'm ready.
Here's what you have to do. You have to match one to tie, two to win. An unlikely possibility. Hey,
what?
Did you hear what happened in the bathroom?
No.
Well, let me tell you. Josephine the plumber blanked the tidy bowl man. Forrest, did you hear what happened in the bathroom? Here it is. Josephine the plumber blanked the tidy bowl man.
Flushed.
Flush. All right. One flush ties.
Same area, different answer. Plunged.
Plunged. No. Plunging is different from flushing. I've done both. What do you say?
I know you have, and you're good at everything.
I said plunge.
Plunge. Yes. Hello, Chuck.
I hope this is a match. I think...
We'll do the best we can for you, sir.
I think so.
Don't plead. It's undignified.
I forgot one part of the E. Flushed.
Flushed. Okay. Now we have a tie score. One more match, and he will win
it.
The game. Right.
Well, he wins. Flushed.
Flushed it is. What do you have there? Flushed. Right to the little blue dot, sir. We'll get to you. Connie, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Oh, thank you so much for the fun.
And we'll have some gifts coming your way, and many thanks for being here on Match Game
PM.
Okay,
thank
Connie
you.
Fisk,
bye.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
While we're spinning her off, we want to spin a message or two just for you. Hurry back and see how he does. Now, Forrest Reed is going to try for a big bundle of money here. You could win over $20,000 here on this Super Match. To do that, we have two audience matches for you. Here we go. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Austin blank. If you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. For matching the second most popular answer, it's $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100.
three of our six stars will offer some helpful, kind assistance.
Fanny?
Austin! Whoops, I have two good ones.
Well, just say one.
Austin! I'll have to go with Austin, Texas.
Austin, Texas. All right.
Dick?
Dick, have you got one?
Austin Healy.
Austin Healy is the name of a car, right.
Charles?
Charles, you can be forgiven if you can't come up with an answer, because this is a very difficult one.
Are there anybody?
No, but I'll say it, because we're running out of time.
Store
right. Austin and Reed.
Do it with a bridge.
That's
you
what
done
the
with
broad wrote, and oh. We're going to go with Austin and Reed.
Anything you say, tough
accent,
guy.
One of the best railroads I've ever been on. Right, and clothing store. And could they pitch?
Austin and Reed, Austin Healy, and Austin, Texas are the three that have been given to you. You have the option of choosing one of those or giving us one of your own.
I have to go with Austin, Texas.
Okay. Let's go over here and find out if we have an Austin, Texas up there anywhere. May we see the $100 number? Austin City Limits. We're getting close to Austin, Texas. Now, wait a minute. We're at the city limits. Can Austin be far behind if we're at the city limits? I ask you, ladies and gentlemen, how far can we be from Austin?
Sounds like a rock group.
It is. Okay, may we see the $250 number? Austin Healy. There you go, Dick. Last chance for Austin, Texas. Go. Yeah.
What's wrong, sir?
What's wrong?
Yes, I ask you, what's
wrong? Austin and Reed were loved. I know that Austin's wife is dead, but Reed's wife, Marcia Reed, could be watching. And Marcia, I'm sorry.
They passed
but
out.
As long as all... No, she didn't, because I know her very well.
Yeah. They're dead here.
They're dead here?
They're dead here. I assure you of that, pal.
I don't have to...
No, sorry.
I don't have an ending to this.
Would you...
When Austin and Reed made the best cough drops money could buy.
Would you take this
hand? Yes!
All right, let's have a go. Let's see how much more money you're going to win with our second audience match. Here we go. I want to go blank. All right, sing out now.
Brett.
I want to go home.
Tab.
I want to go back.
I want to go back.
To where I come from.
To where I come from.
Fanny.
I want to go to the ladies... To the
I want to go.
I want to go now.
Okay, that's it, whatever that is. I want to go back, I want to go home, and I want to go, period. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What is your pleasure here?
I want to go home.
Okay. Let's go down there at the bottom. Begin with the $100 number.
That's what I want.
That's what she said. You were right all along.
Yes, yeah. I know.
All right, maybe see the $250 number.
I want to go
back. Oh. 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 Oh, where were you when I needed you?
Brett says that all
right.
the time.
Last chance for I want to go home here. Slide the big one.
Yay!
Yeah, you got it. Okay. Now, Forrest has won another $500 multiplied by 10 makes $5,000. And we're going to add that to the previous $5,000 he won, which means the least you'll be playing for is $10,000. However, you can double that stake if you have a lucky spin of the star wheel. Give it a spin and find out where it stops to see which star you'll be playing with. If it stops anywhere in the star area, you double your money. Let's see if we get a double.
$10,000
or $20,000. There it is. For $20,000. Good luck here. Here it is. Blank of the morning. Blank of the morning. Okay, Charles has finished, Forrest. You give us the answer that he's written on the card. We give you $20,000. Blank of the morning.
Top of the morning.
Top of the morning. Okay, Charles. He says top of the morning will match you for the 20,000. What do you say to that?
I said what Austin and Reed said when they thought. Then they thought everyone hated Austin and Reed, and they were forgotten. And I called up Millicent Reed. She's so wonderful. And I said, Millicent, Austin and Reed are still on top.
This fella just won $21,000. We congratulate Paul Creed. Tune in next week. We'll see if we can give away another bundle with more stars on Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Good night.
Some contestants will receive the Atlanta Tuckamatic from the radar range, Michael Rebell.
Carburetor cleaner by Pennzoil. Helps keep your car free from slow starts, clutching, and stalling. Gum out. And between tune-ups, tune-up. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production.